Okay, so now that we've gone over the product rule, next we're going to look at the quotient rule, which is when you actually, instead of multiplying two functions, you divide them. So in this case, we're going to take f of x divided by g of x. And what happens here is it's this complicated formula shown here that can be memorized fairly easily if you follow this pattern. So you say, assume that the g of x is low because it's on the low side of the fraction, and the f of x is high because it's on the high side of the fraction. So what you say is you say low d high, and you say d because it's a derivative, minus high d low all over low, because it's the low g of x squared. Okay, and so using this, you can calculate the derivatives of two functions divided by each other. So in order to show this, we'll do the same thing we did with the quotient rule. So I'll solve this problem once through algebra, and then a second time through the quotient rule. And hopefully they match. Okay. So through algebra, what we do if we take this problem, we would try to factor the top, and luckily we can, which has been set up for us. So we factor it to x minus 1, x plus 2, and if you multiply this out, you would get the same numerator of that function, and the bottom is x minus 1. So what happens here is because we factored it nicely, we get a point discontinuity, and we can cancel those out. And we are left with x plus 2 derivative, which is just equal to 1. So the derivative of this guy is just 1 if we use algebra. So now let's take a look by using the quotient rule. So using the quotient rule, let me start with the high function, which is f of x. So f of x is going to be the top of our function that we're trying to do. So x squared plus x minus 2. And since we're going to need its derivative, let's just go ahead and take it now. So derivative of this is going to be derivative of x squared is 2x. Derivative of x is 1. And the derivative of minus 2 is just 0. So there's nothing there. Okay. That's all using the power rule. G of x, it's the low function up here. So we see that as x minus 1. And the derivative of g of x is going to be the derivative of x, which is 1, and the derivative of minus 1, which is 0. So that's it. It's just 1. So now let's take our low d high minus high d low over low, right? So low is the first one, so that's going to be x minus 1. D high, so D high is going to be the f prime of x we found already, 2x plus 1. Okay, then we're going to minus high D low, so high is just going to be the f of x here, x squared plus x minus 2. And then D low, so that's the derivative of the low, which is given here, so that's just 1, so multiply by that. So far we've figured out the numerator here. And then when we go down to the bottom, we take g of x squared, or low. So g of x squared, so that's going to be right here, x minus 1 squared, x minus 1 squared. And if you are taking a course, it is important to kind of lay out all these steps where you show that you know the formula, you show that you know what each thing is, and then you try to do it. So if you make a mistake, you get partial credit. Okay, now we just need to simplify this guy. So let's start. So first of all, we gotta multiply this guy out. So we get 2x squared plus x minus 2x minus 1. And then again, this minus falls across to each. So minus x squared minus x plus 2 and multiplied by 1. So that goes away. All over x minus 1 squared. All right, so now let's take a different color here and let's see what can cancel out. So we get a minus 2x a plus x and a minus x. Oh, whoops. So those do hang around. So this guy's okay. So this guy stays. But the plus x and the minus x cancel out, right? The plus 2 and the minus 1, so we end up with plus 1. So I'll rewrite this guy as 2x up here. And then the minus x squared and the 2x squared, we simplify just to x squared. So what are we left with? Well, we're left with x squared minus 2x plus 1 on top divided by x minus 1 squared. So this doesn't quite look like 1, but again, now if we factor the top, what do we get? Well, factoring the top, we get x minus 1 times x minus 1 all over x minus 1 squared. So this is equivalent to squared over x minus 1 squared. These guys cancel, and so your derivative is 1. Okay? So we get the same answer for both of those, whether we use the algebra way or the quotient rule. So memorize this, add this to your list of rules, and we'll keep using it in the future. Thanks.